Welcome to Katori Saruna Prison. I'm going to be taking care of you today. My name is Betty Wright, also known as Betty White. When I was younger, my mama decided to name me her after her. She's a gorgeous woman. Let me tell you, she's still got it. So, I'm going to be doing the natural frisk. Some other jails / prisons do naked frisks, but they gave you a little bit of clothes to wear. I also have the bag that was on you when you were arrested. So I'd shake your hand, but you're in cuffs. But I can make a promise to you that if you don't grab me, I won't grab you. Not too hard. So you want me to take these cuffs off you? We can begin the frisk, and I'll even take off my gun, make sure it's nice and unloaded. Usually we're supposed to have it loaded when we get a new inmate. That's okay, that's okay. I'm just going to radio in my fellow officers and let them know that you're here safe with me. That way, if you try anything silly, because I did review your record a little bit, and it says you're a liar, that you were mentally diagnosed as a psychological liar. That's okay, because like I said, if we can establish a trust, we'll be nice and green. Paging Officer 2290. This is Officer Betty Wright letting you know that Jenna 10 is in the building, nice and safe. Okay. So, I'm going to explain a little bit what I'm going to be doing today, and then I'll remove your cuffs, and we'll go through your bag, and we'll deal with all that kind of stuff, okay? So first things first, I'm going to have to get a little information off you after we look through your bag. I'm going to have to ask you your height, your weight, your full name. I'm going to need you to tell the truth, sweetheart, because it appears that you're being charged for having like 3 social security numbers, which honestly is probably one of the hardest things to do. So we're going to figure that out. Then I'm going to write down all that information, put it in an envelope, and we're going to start a new information. I'm going to put on a mask before I open the bag in case you threw some anthrax or something in there. No worries, no worries. We're all friends here. We don't like to be attacked or shot at or stabbed or hair pulled or cut whenever we're not looking with homemade scissors, but that's okay. So I'm going to put on a mask and then go through your bag, again, ask you some of your information, then I'm going to put on a brand new pair of gloves, and we're going to do the frisk. And again, like I said, you have a nice pair of clothes on. I got a baggy shirt on because we're not allowed to wear much tight things around here because of the male and or female inmates, which is completely okay. Sexuality you are, but it's just our requirements. So please forgive me. Please forgive me. So I'm going to be doing a last check. I'm going to be looking in your eyes. We don't use flashlights because our inmates like to say that they have seizures when they really don't, and then get sent to medical, and then that'll be put on their jail time sentence. So, but on the good news is I heard that you're having a visit in 2 days from now, so that's exciting. But are you ready? Alright, now again, I'm going to remove your cuffs, and I have an unloaded gun just sitting behind me with the clip right next to it. So we're going to establish some trust whether you're a liar or not. So put your hands out and let me reach for the key. Okay, here's the key. So, let me see here. Oh no, doll, I understand, I understand, so I have to put these back on you at the end. I apologize, so enjoy the last of your freedom, though. Yeah, these are the real deal cuffs, the ones you cannot get out of. So, I'll just put those on behind me next to my gun. No worries, no worries. Alright, so, let's get our mask. We start with a brand new fresh mask every time we do a frisk or take in a new inmate. I'm sorry if my makeup is a little bit too much. You know, waking up with freedom and all, I didn't really have time because I had to get here to take away people's freedom like yours, but that's okay. That's okay. It's not too bad here. That's why we're really nice. Because we don't. With a pack of 10. We're only going to take one. I have this one opposite way. Oh, good golly, Miss Molly. Hold on one second. That's okay. There we go. That's a lot better. Okay. I'm going to put that down here till we get your bag. Your bag's right here. I'll probably get rid of here. Alright. Are you ready to do the deed? Miss Jen? I think that you came in here trying to say your name was Miss Karuna. Miss Karuna Satori from YouTube? Crazy, crazy. Do it. It's your bag. A nice Tommy Hilfiger. Cheap, but at the same time says you're middle class. But I know Miss Karuna personally. Actually, I think I drew a picture of Miss Karuna. No, sweetie, you're not Karuna Satori. Your name is Jen. Jen Tan. Literally rhymes. No, people didn't draw pictures of you, honey. You look a little bit like Karuna Satori, but you're not anything special. Not being disrespectful, everybody has a story, but Karuna Satori is not you. We don't actually put the gloves in. Until I frisk you, but you're making me not trust you. You know what? No. I'll let it slide for now. But I'm going to use this magnifying glass. We like to have fun here. I like sounds of certain things. I like when I get to go home after a long day taking care of people like you. And I like to listen to all the sounds that the outside world makes. When I leave work, I like tapping on things. I like mouth sounds. Not the kind of mouth sounds I hear walking past two females inmates at night, but we can only do what we can. So let's get through this bag, Miss Karuna Satori. First things first, a shirt, let's say, don't need that when I'm looking through a shirt, has 90s characters on it, so here's what I'm going to do, I'm going to start my information now. But this is gone. You'll get that one day if you ever get out of here with what you did. So let's write down right here. You know what? I'm going to get some of your information right now. That way after this we can go straight to the frisking. Frisking, frisking, frisking. So your real name again is Jen Tan. Alias Karuna Satori. All right, dear. How tall do you think you are? You're not 5'7", that's Karuna. Honey, I don't know if this is a mental problem or what, but I read your record. In fact, I think I have your record right here. Alias is Karuna Satori. You said you're 5'7 like her, 115 like her. Let's see, I was told not to believe that you were an artist, excuse me, that you were an artiste, that you had really expensive products in your bag, probably, that you had some sketches you drew of other people. Oh, doll. Honey, in the law, you can't lie to the law. Yeah. So let's get your real weight, or else we're going to have to weigh you. Estimated weight. You'll be weighed after this. Okay? You're a pretty thin type. What gender do you identify as? What's your sexuality? Your race? Any history of AIDS, herpes, syphilis, any other STD? I'm just going to put unknown, dear, because you'll get your gyno checks soon enough. But you don't have Hep C, Hep B, Hep A, any kind of hepatitis, anything that if I accidentally cut you for some reason, you're not going to bleed into a disease. Great. All right, so I think I got most information here, just the basis of this. And we can continue going through your bag in inmates. Bag is shirt with 90s graphics. Next. Well, what do we got here? Cracked wood, natural quality wood products. It is a big value. Let's see here. Wooden. What is this? Doll, I read your paper now. What is this? Simply sketching pencils, crayons, graphites, getting stiffed, lapiches de esposo. What are these used for? Writing. I thought you were a sketch artist from what I was told. Pencils. Over there where they'll get confiscated. Silver, silver, blue, orange, purple, yellow. Not in the color of the rainbow. All right, dear, why do you have these paints on you? Are any of them lead-based or filled with anthrax or poisons we should be concerned about because they're getting thrown in the garbage? Yeah, these won't be kept. Paints to be thrown. Next, Now, dear, why in God's name do we have a heart chakra on a halter? Scented candle. Right. I'm sure you were using it for tarot card readings. Were you lying to them too? I'm sorry. It's not my place to judge. Scented candle to be thrown away. Let's see. More things, it appears. Two books. Wreck this journal with now even more ways to Rick by Carrie Smith. Here's, there's a few things in here. Drawings by you, I'm assuming. Let's see. Let's go through a couple of these. We have some tags. Did you do this, Artist of the Year? I don't know if you put any powders in this or not, but I'm still going to look through it. Let's see. I'm getting stuff all over my hands. This page is for fingerprints or fingerprints. Get them dirty, then press down. Oh, so you did do this. How sweet. Very nice, very nice. Friday, January 30th, 2014 at 2:26 p.m. Draw fat lines in thin, pushing really hard with the pencil. Let's see here. Can't really. There we go. There we go. What's it say right here? This looks like a 3D hand. Did you do all this? This is actually pretty good. I am aware I should have used marker for this attempt at a 3D hand, but I am also aware that mistakes are part of the process. This was on 1/31 at 12 a.m. 2014. What's this? Methadone, 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 methadone. The instructions say to write one word over and over, and there's a little tag with a number on it. It just says methadone 1,000 times, then methadone 1,000 times more in the background. With a eyeball that's kind of small, kind of scared. And somebody with red hair, with a bun, drinking, it looks like, a vial of methadone. Methadone, methadone, methadone. This was made on 2/1/2014 at 12:35 at night. Huh. And then this little tag right here says, product of society. 2207 must be their identification number at one time. So you did this? Is this yours? You're on methadone, because it sure does state that your drug screening came back clean as a whistle, whistle, whistle. Like this. Well, the ball fell out of this, so not really like that, but something like it. Let's see. Is there any identification? Did you put your identification in here? Glue items to things. We got some goat milk. A whisper passage. Bridge to Lust Valley. Anything else? Pretend you are doodling on the back of an envelope while on the phone. I don't know. There's really nothing in here but that methadone sketch, man. Somebody must have been pained. Because I don't believe it's yours, sweetheart. Color the entire page. That's really nice if you really did it. But I'm going to find out who is the owner of this. Usually it's in the front or the back. Right here. I knew it. Your name isn't Sarah Deshawn. I believe that's Karina Sartorius. Do you have a record journal who belongs to Karina Sartori? Because this appears to be her name written 1,000 times with an address that I'm covering up from you. we're confiscating this and we're going to return it to its rightful owner once we speak to Karuna. So, yeah. Alright. Back to, I don't want to know why you stole somebody's work, but sweetheart, I'm very upset. That's not yours. That wasn't yours to take, okay? And the last item in this bag is... bag gets confiscated. This notebook, which I was told to make sure I wore the mask for this. ASMR tags, ASMR, popular ASMR, male ASMR, ASMR haircut. Let's say, oh, is that one of our drug dogs again? Tisk, 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 tisk. It has a couple sketches in here, but I think we're going to keep that because I have a feeling this is stolen too. Well, that's your bag, dear. And we've got two alleged stolen items that's going to be investigated, so let's write this down. Alright, so we're almost done with the information. I just got to do a quick frisk. A quick frisk. So now, I'm going to be putting these on. They're just pairs of thick gloves, latex. I'm actually allergic to latex. That's why I really don't like this job, because of people like you. Because the less latex I have to use on a daily basis, the happier Miss Betty Wright is. So let's see. Oh, my wrap's right off. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I throw trash around your feet? My bad. I'm sorry. I know not to be mean. It's just you shouldn't be taking stuff that isn't yours. I just don't understand it, you know? Smells like death. Smells like death row. Alright, let's get these on and start with the last check. Overall, nerve examination. Just gotta make sure you're clean. Make sure you're not hiding anything. One size fits all my arse. Too tight. I mean, come on. These new brands they bring into this prison. You know what? I'm just starting to get irritated, honestly. Just keep one glove on, but that's all right. Just get boned, doing the job. All So first things first, I'm just gonna go and do a touchdown of your body. I really don't have to ask if I can touch you. May I touch you? Yeah, it doesn't really matter, does it? There's gonna be a lot more things touching you than my hands. Okay, so first thing, I'm just feeling your head, down your shoulders, and around. Okay, neck, under the jaw, shoulders, lift up your shoulders for me. Put your hands, lift them up. Great. Moving your hand around, feeling for anything. Okay, I need you to squat down. Literally squat down, legs up pretty much. All right, now say your ABCs. I'll say them with you. Ready? A, B, C, D. Keep squatting. C, D, E, F, G. Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, and Y, and Z. You don't have to do the ABCs. All right, stand up. Turn around. Just going to go through your hair a little bit. I know it doesn't feel good against these gloves, but... just feeling your back a little bit. Patting it down, making sure you have nothing hidden. Going down to your legs, feeling up in between, making sure there's nothing there. You squatted, something would have fell out, trust me. Kegels don't do much when you're squatting, dear. All right, stand back up, sit back down. I'm going to check your face a little bit, make sure there is no hidden anthrax. Brilliant. All right, now for the last check, I just need you to sit down and relax. This is the last relaxing you're gonna do for a long time. I'm just gonna comb through your hair a little bit and then use this side to part it, flip it, pinch it, dig in it, make sure there's no knits. Let's do it. Okay, so I'm just gonna comb through your hair right now. In my honest suggestion, I think that you should consider getting it cut in here. That'll make you look like a stereotype, but that's okay. People in jail seem to judge more than others, but then after a while of being in jail, you learn that's not the case, and that everybody pretty much is accepting one another, and they're just fearing everything that's happening to them every single moment. But you just gotta be, okay, the sides here. Back. All right, let's part. Let's part. You're gonna be seeing me a lot more often, dear. Hold on. Good. Part. Flip. Open. Looking for any knits. Just keep your head down. Got these tweezers here. I think I might have found something. Can't get it. This honestly looks like dandruff. Right in your direction, right back at you, doll. Okay, now, let's do this. Part, flip, open, look. Okay, you seem to be good on that. Now let's do the other side. Part, flip, open, look. All right. And one more, pretty much, and then I'm just gonna scruff through your hair real quick. Part, flip, open, inspect. Let's say, have we found a knit? A knit. Nope, dandruff. Well, we're pretty much done with this. Let me just comb this back over and make your hair look super nice. Alright. Well, that seems to be it, doll. I've seemed to do everything I needed to do for you today. Right on time, too. Seems that it is on this thing 10 after midnight. Yeah, it's pretty late. You better enjoy tonight being an intake this late at night, because you were arraigned by a judge and your bond was $1.2 million. 10% of that, it's not looking good for you, sweetie, but that's all right. So what I want you to do is just relax tonight, because I think in 2 days you get a visit. Yeah, your very first visit, 2 days after you're taken in, which is really rare, but I just need to refer this information to the jail. You're an intake, you're in the jail, but I gotta put it in an envelope for HIPAA violations, which you're an inmate, you're not really worth much in human life, but I'm kidding. Compassion, everybody should have compassion. You'll get a pack of these, actually, but they'll be open with a little rubber band that gets cut when you get them. That way you can't use it as a weapon for anybody, especially if you're put on suicide watch. That would be no envelopes, no nothing. So if you have any mail coming in, the jail is going to have to look through it. You're expecting pictures. Oh yeah? What kind of pictures? Sketches? Remember, and I'm gonna warn you something right now, sweetie. You get any stolen property thrown in this jail, that'll be adding sentence after sentence after sentence. It's horrifying. All right. Let's get this information, get these cuffs back on you, and get you sent over to quarantine for the night. Okay. Just need to put down that you... Brilliant. All right, my dearest. I don't really like to lick and stick anymore because of a Seinfeld episode where George's girlfriend licked too many stamps and died. All right, I'm just gonna put your identification number in there. And that is 2206, not 2207, sweetheart. Okay. Katori Saruna Prison. And this is your information. You can't really see it real well, but it says Katori Saruna, 2206, jail, or prison, my bad. All right, dear. I wish you the best, but you'll be doing just fine. So, you know, just tough it out. How long's your sentence? Oh, again, tough it out. You'll be fine. They all are. They're all still alive. And that's all that matters, isn't it? Can't seem to get this key out. There we go. Alright, let's get your first arm. Or first, yeah, wrist in here. Let me see your left wrist. Alright. Alright, and right wrist. Alright, go ahead and put your arms down. Relax. And somebody will be in here to take you very soon, okay? Alright, dear. It was really nice meeting you. I'm going to load up my gun now because I have 3 more intakes at 12:30 at night. I don't know. Alright, dear. You be safe now, and I'll see you 2 days from now because I actually manage the visitations. So I'll see you again very soon. I do inmates and intakes and irrigations and all kinds of stuff. So I'll see you soon, dear. It was nice meeting you. Have a great life. I know I'll be having a better one. Bye.